This has been the most emotional day for these families who have finally gotten some terrible news after hearing from authorities here in Malaysia that their loved ones are all gone. It was too much for many of these families to bear. The families here in Kuala Lumpur were in a briefing before the media got the information. One of them came bursting out the doors, screaming, why, over and over again. Another had to be wheeled out in a wheelchair, sobbing. There was yet another mother, a mother who we have seen before, have a complete meltdown where she was screaming, where's my son? Where's my son? She was the same woman who was inside of the press conference where police ended up taking her away. That was a few days ago. Now she's hearing this terrible news that authorities do now believe from satellite data that the plane actually did go down in the Indian Ocean. This has been a day that families did not want to come because many of them thought that perhaps there was a sliver of a chance, even after 17 days, nearly more than half a month, that perhaps their family members were still alive. That little bit of hope kept them going. And to hear this information, they were just overwrought with emotion. In Beijing, the situation was similar. There were family members who were screaming, we need proof. We don't believe you. We want proof, because they've been given so much information that turned out not to be true that they simply cannot accept what they're hearing from officials. They do not want to accept that perhaps their family members are gone forever and that perhaps they may never see that proof. If this plane is far enough into the Indian Ocean in deep enough waters, it may be nearly impossible for authorities to be able to get to it. That is what authorities are working on right now, trying to find the evidence, the physical evidence that this plane actually did go down in the southern corridor in the Indian Ocean off the coast of Perth, far off the coast of Perth. Right now, the family members are trying to determine what it is they're going to do next, whether or not they will be going to Perth, going to Australia, closer to where the investigation is, or whether or not they'll be staying put here in Kuala Lumpur and in Beijing. All that will be decided right now. Family members are trying to cope with devastating news from the government that all has been lost. Sarah Seidner, Kuala Lumpur.